Today we are going to start Banach algebras. So first of all, what is algebra? An algebra A over a field F. F may be R, may be C. R means set of real number and C means set of complex number. Is a vector space such that for each ordered pair xy belongs to A, there exists a unique product xy belongs to A, which satisfy the following properties. Property number one, A property, which is associative in multiplications. Property number B, which is a distributive, x into y plus z, which is equal to xy plus xz. Similarly, x plus y into z, which is equal to xz plus yz. And last property, property number D, which is a alpha into xy, which is equal to alpha x into y, and which is equal to x into alpha y. Where for it is for every xy belongs to A, and alpha belongs to F. F mean field. If F is a R, if field is the set of real number, then algebra A is called a real algebra. If F is capital C and F is a set of complex number, then algebra A is called complex algebra. So in general, the definition of algebra is vector space and ring. Algebra is a vector space and ring with one additional property, that is property number D, which means alpha into xy, which is equal to alpha x into y, equal to x into alpha y. So that is a definition of algebra. So remember one thing, algebra is a vector space as well as it is a ring, and in addition of these two, it satisfies the property number D. What is commutative algebra? So any algebra is commutative, or second name is abelian, if it satisfies commutative property. Similarly, algebra with identity, if there exists E belongs to A such that Ex equal to Xe for every X belongs to A, then it means it is a, E is called identity of algebra, and algebra A is called algebra with identity. What is subalgebra? Subalgebra is subspace M of algebra A, is called linear subalgebra of A if it satisfies the property for every xy belongs to M, where M is subset of A, the product xy is also belongs to M, then capital M is called subalgebra. We can also say that M is a part of A, M is a subset of A, one thing, and second thing is M itself is a algebra, then M is called a subalgebra of algebra A. So first theorem is, in the algebra, the identity is unique. Now, in order to prove the identity is unique, we take two identities. Let E and E dash be identity of algebra A. Now, by definition of identity, we can write Ex equal to Xe, which is equal to X for every X belongs to A, equation number one. Similarly, for identity E dash, we can write it as E dash X, which is equal to Xe dash, equal to X for every X belongs to A. Now, equation number one is satisfied for every X belongs to A. It means equation one is satisfied for every member of A. Similarly, equation 2 is satisfied for every member of A. Now, in equation number one, we know that E dash is also member of A. So this equation is satisfied for E dash. Similarly, E is also member of A. So this condition, equation number two, is also satisfied for E. So in particular, this equation number one becomes E into E dash, which is equal to E dash into E, which is equal to E dash. Similarly, equation number two, that will become E dash into E, which is equal to E into E dash, which is equal to E. Now from these two equations, the left hand side, E into E dash and this E into E dash, they are equal. If they are equal, then E dash is equal to E. So it implies E dash is equal to E, which prove the uniqueness of identity. Next definition is normed algebra. What is normed algebra? A normed algebra A is a normed linear space. Basically, it is a normed algebra. It is an algebra with norm. So which satisfy the additional two properties. Property number one, norm of xy less than equal to norm of x in norm of y, for every xy belongs to A. Number two, norm of E, which is equal to 1. So identity, E means identity. So norm of E is equal to 1. So this is a definition of norm algebra. What is Banach algebra? Basically, a complete norm algebra is called a Banach algebra. So this Banach algebra is normed algebra as well as it is a complete. It means in this algebra, every Cauchy sequence is convergent. So first result, in normed algebra A, multiplication of vector space is continuous. It means if any sequence xn converges to x, yn converges to y, then it implies their product xn into yn converges to x into y. Now proof. Now first let xn approaches to x and yn approaches to y. It implies norm of xn minus x approaches to 0 and norm of yn minus y approaches to 0 as n approaches to infinity. That is in equation number 1. Norm of xn into yn minus xy can be written as xn yn minus xny plus xny minus xy. So by triangle inequality, that is in normed space. So by triangle inequality, this term is less, this term here it should be, this term is less than equal to norm of first term plus norm of second term. So correct this equality, here it is less than equal to. So I repeat again, norm of this sum by using triangle inequality, it should be less than equal to norm of first term plus norm of second term. So here we use the property of normed space. Now, this can be written in this form. So it is a product of two vectors xn into yn minus y. Now we use the property of normed algebra. So property of normed algebra, norm of xy less than equal to norm of x into norm of y. So this is again less than equal to norm of first vector into norm of second vector plus norm of first vector into norm of second vector. Now from this, this term is approaches to zero and this sequence is bounded because xn is a convergent sequence. Every convergent sequence is bounded. If it is a bounded and this sequence approaches to zero, so this product approaches to zero. Similarly, norm of xn minus x approaches to zero. And this total term is again approaches to zero. So this approaches to zero as n approaches to infinity. It means norm of xn yn minus xy approaches to zero as n approaches to infinity. It implies xn yn approaches to xy as n approaches to infinity. So which prove our result. So these are some example of Banach algebra. So set of real number capital R. It is a commutative Banach algebra with identity 1. Similarly, set of complex number, it is again commutative Banach algebra with identity 1. Now C of AB, it is a set of all continuous function defined on closed interval. It is a Banach space with norm defined by norm of f, which is equal to supremum of absolute value of fx. X belongs to closed interval AB. So it is again a Banach algebra. Similarly, we can consider a open unit disk D in complex plane, and A of D is the set of all analytic function in unit disk D and continues in D. Norm of f is defined in this form. Clear? So again, this is a Banach algebra. Now, next definition is of regular unit or invertible. If A is algebra with identity E, an element x belongs to A is said to be invertible. If there exists a x inverse belongs to A such that x into x inverse, which is equal to x inverse into x, is equal to identity. So the second name of invertible is unit, and third name is it is a regular. So regular mean invertible, invertible mean unit. Now remember two things. If vector is regular, then it means invertible. If vector is singular, then it means it is a non-invertible. So these are very important to remember, that regular mean invertible, singular mean non-invertibles. After that, the next definition, resolvent. Resolvent and spectrum is very important definition. So first, we discuss the resolvent. If A is complex algebra with identity, then resolvent is denoted by rho. R for resolvent, R for rho, and R for regular. So remember these three things, three R. R for resolvent, R for rho, and R for regular. Rho of X, which is set of all lambda which belongs to C, complex number, such that x minus lambda e is regular. It means x minus lambda e is non-singular. It means x minus lambda e is unit. It means x minus lambda e is invertible. It means x minus lambda e inverse exist. So this lambda is called a regular values. Then x minus lambda e inverse exist. Now after that, spectrum. So spectrum is denoted by sigma of x. S for spectrum, S for sigma. So this is a sigma. And it consists all values of lambda such that x minus lambda e is singular. So it has 3s, spectrum, sigma, and singular. Singular means non-invertible, and this lambda is called spectral values. Now this is very important result. Let A be complex Banach algebra with identity E if X belongs to A satisfy this condition: norm of X minus E less than 1, then X is regular, ja X is invertible, and X inverse can be written in the form of series that is represented in equation number E. Now remember that this norm can be written as E minus X. It is also changed by, replaced by E minus X. Why? Because if we take minus 1 into E minus X, the norm of minus 1, that is in converted into minus 1 in absolute value of minus 1. So both are the same. We can say that norm of X minus E and norm of E minus X are same. So this term can be replaced by E minus X. In order to prove this result, we take this term is equal to P because it is a sum number. So let P is equal to norm of X minus E. It implies P is less than 1, that is by given part. Again, norm of Y raised to power N less than equal to norm of Y raised to power N. This condition is satisfied because of the first property of normed algebra. What is the first property of normed algebra? Which is norm of XY less than equal to norm of X into norm of Y. By using that property, norm of Y raised to power N, which is equal to norm of Y into Y into Y up to N times, which is less than equal to norm of Y into norm of Y into norm of Y up to N times. So this can be written as norm of Y raised to power N. Now the series, this series can be by using property of triangle inequality. This is less than equal to this values, and this can be written as less than equal to summation n equal to 1 raised to power infinity norm of E minus X raised to power N. So what is this? It is a P. So P raised to power N. Now what is this? It is a GP series with a common ratio P, and P is less than 1. If GP series with common ratio less than 1, in that case the series is convergent. So this series is convergent. If this series is convergent, the left hand side summation n running from 1 to infinity E minus X raised to power n convergent absolutely, because we take in term of norm, right? So this is converge absolutely. If it converge absolutely, then its nth partial sum of series form a Cauchy sequence in A. So what is A? A is a Banach space. Banach space is complete. So every Cauchy sequence in complete space is a convergent. So it implies this series is a convergent. So we prove the first part, the series is a convergent. Now let the right hand side of this term, this right hand side of this term, we take this entire term is equal to small y, and our purpose is show that X inverse equal to Y. If we want to show that x inverse is equal to y, then we want to prove that x into y should be identity. X into y and y into x, it should be identity. Now we take this right hand side of this equation is equal to y. So let small y, which is equal to e plus mission n running from 1 to infinity, e minus x raised to power n. Then y minus xy, this y can be written as e into y minus xy by using property of identity. And this can be written as e minus x into y. So this can be written as, now by substituting the value of y, this can be written by this equation. Again, simplify, we get this equation. So what is this? It is small y minus e. Now this term and this term neutralize each other. Then what we get? We get xy equal to identity. Similarly, we can show that yx equal to identity. It implies xy into yx, which is equal to identity. It implies x inverse equal to y. So it implies x inverse, which is equal to e plus summation of e minus x raised to power n, which prove the result. Next result is similar to previous result. Now in this statement, let A be complex Banach algebra with unity if X belongs to A such that norm of X less than 1, then E minus X is invertible and E minus X inverse, which is equal to E plus summation of n is running from 1 to infinity, x raised to power n. Clear. Now this result is similar to previous result. So only we replace e minus x by x in previous result. Then it means x is invertible and e minus x inverse, which is equal to e plus summation x raised to power n, and that is in equation number 1. In addition to that result, we want to show that norm of e minus x inverse minus e minus x less than equal to norm of x whole square over 1 minus norm of x. Now from this equation, from equation number 1, e minus x raised to power minus 1 minus e minus x, which is equal to summation of n running from 2 to infinity tak, and x raised to power n. Now taking norm on both sides by using triangle inequality, so this is less than equal to summation norm of x raised to power n. So this is a series norm of x raised to power 2 plus norm of x raised to power 3 plus so on up to infinity. So it is a GP series. It is a infinite GP series with first term norm of x raised to power 2 and common ratio is norm of x. So by using the sum of series result, it is equal to norm of x whole square, which is a over 1 minus r, norm of x whole square over 1 minus norm of x. This is 1 minus norm of x because this is less than 1. So it proves the result. After that, let A be a complex Banach algebra with identity E, and G is a set which consisting only regular values, with regular vector, which consisting all x belongs to A, such that x inverse exists. Our purpose is to prove that G is a group. So simply, we want to show that G is a subgroup. Now, since identity belongs to G, then it implies G does not, G is non-empty. If G is non-empty, so we can take any vector from the G. Let XY belongs to G. Since X and Y belongs to G, then it means X inverse and Y inverse exist. If X inverse and Y inverse exist, we can write it as X into X inverse, which is equal to X inverse into X equal to E. Similarly, Y into Y inverse, which is equal to Y inverse into Y, which is equal to E. So now, if we take XY into Y inverse into X inverse, this can be written X into Y inverse into X inverse. This is equal to identity. So XE into X inverse, this is again equal to X. So the entire term is equal to identity. Similarly, if we take this on left hand side, again this term will become identity. So from this, XY into Y inverse X inverse equal to identity, which is equal to Y inverse X inverse into XY. So this is equal to identity. It means this term is inverse of this term and this term is inverse of this term. So XY inverse can be written as Y inverse into X inverse. Since X inverse exists and belongs to G, and Y inverse also exists, so it means this term exists, this term exists, so right hand side is exist. If XY inverse exists, then it means XY belongs to G, then G is a subgroup. If G is a subgroup, then G is a group, which proves